This is the message we heard and proclaim to you. God is light, in whom there is no darkness at all. Jesus Christ is the light of the world, and this is the judgment, that the light has come into the world, and we loved darkness rather than light.
He had no form or majesty that we should look at him, nothing in his appearance that we should desire him.
We despised him and rejected him.
A man of sorrows and acquainted with bitter grief.
We turned our backs on him and looked the other way when he went by.
He was despised and we didn't care.
Yet it was our grief he bore, our sorrow that weighed him down.
And we thought his troubles were a punishment from God.
But he was wounded for our transgressions, crushed for our iniquities.
He was whipped, and we have peace. He was lashed, and we are healed.
We are the ones who have strayed away like sheep. We who left God's paths to follow our own. Yet God laid on him the guilt and sins of us all.
Pilate then called together the chief priests, the leaders, and the people, and said to them, "You brought me this man as one who was perverting the people, and here I have examined him in your presence and have not found this man guilty of any charges against him. Neither has Herod, for he sent him back to us. Indeed, he has done nothing to deserve death. I will therefore have him flogged and release him." Then they all shouted out together, "Away with this fellow! Release Barabbas for us." This was a man who had been put in prison for an insurrection that had taken place in the city and for murder. Pilate, wanting to release Jesus, addressed them again, but they kept shouting, "Crucify! Crucify him!" A third time he said to them, "Why, what evil has he done? I have found him no ground for the sentence of death. I will therefore have him flogged and then release him." But they kept urgently demanding with loud shouts that he should be crucified, and their voices prevailed. So Pilate gave his verdict, that their demand should be granted. He released the man they asked for, the one who had been put in prison for insurrection and murder. And he handed Jesus over as they wished. Two others also, who were criminals, were led away to be put to death with him. When they came to the place that is called the Skull, they crucified Jesus there with the criminals, one on his right and one on his left. Then Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing." And they cast lots to divide his clothing. And the people stood by, watching. But the leaders scoffed him and saying, "He saved others, let him save himself, if he is the Messiah of God, his chosen one." The soldiers also mocked him, coming up and offering him sour wine and saying, "If you are the King of the Jews, save yourself." There was also an inscription over him, "This is the King of the Jews." Let us pray, Almighty God, our Redeemer.
In our weakness, we have failed to be your messengers of forgiveness and hope in this world. Renew us by your Holy Spirit, that we may follow your commands and proclaim your reign of love. Amen.
Today you will be with me in paradise. One of the criminals who were hanged there kept deriding him and saying, "Are you not the Messiah? Save yourself and us." But the other rebuked him, saying, Do you not fear God, since you are under the same sentence of condemnation? And we indeed have been condemned justly, for we are getting what we deserve for our deeds. But this man has done nothing wrong. Then he said, Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. He replied, truly I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise. Let us pray. Lord Jesus,
your kingdom has broken into our troubled world through the life, death, and resurrection of your Son. Help us to hear your word and obey it, so that we become instruments of your redeeming love. Amen.
Here is your son, here is your mother. Meanwhile, standing near the cross of Jesus were his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing beside her, he said to his mother, woman, here is your son. And then he said to the disciple, here is your mother. And from that hour, the disciple took her into his own home. Let us pray. Eternal Lord, we ask you to look with mercy on your family, for whom our Lord Jesus Christ was willing to be betrayed and to be given over to the hands of sinners and to suffer death on the cross, who now lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. My God, why have you forsaken me? From noon on, darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m. At about 3:00, Jesus cried with a loud voice, Eli, Eli, lema sabachthani? That is, my God, why have you forsaken me? When some of the bystanders heard it, they said, this man is calling for Elijah. At once, one of them ran and got a sponge, filled it with sour wine, put it on a stick, and gave it to him to drink. But the other said, wait, let us see whether Elijah will come to save him. Let us pray. Eternal Lord, your Son, our Savior, suffered at the hands of men and endured the shame of the cross. Grant that we may walk in the way of the cross and find it the way of life and peace. Amen.
I am thirsty. After this, when Jesus knew that all was now finished, he said, in order to fulfill the scripture, I am thirsty. A jar full of sour wine was standing there. So they put a sponge full of the wine on a branch of hyssop and held it to his mouth. Let us pray. Almighty God,
you have called us to follow you. Grant that our love may not grow cold in your service, and that we may not fail or deny you in the hour of trial. Amen.
When Jesus had received the wine, he said, "It is finished." Then he bowed his head and gave up his spirit. Let us pray. Almighty God,
your Son chose the path which led to pain before joy, and the cross before glory. Plant this cross in our hearts, so that in its power and love, we may come at last to joy and glory. Amen.
Into thy hands I commit my spirit. It was now about noon, and darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m. While the sun's light failed, and the curtain of the temple was torn in two, then Jesus, crying with a loud voice, said, "Father, into your hands I commend my spirit." Having said this, he breathed his last. When the centurion saw what had taken place, he praised God and said, "Certainly this man was innocent." And when all the crowds who had gathered there for this spectacle saw what had taken place, they returned home, beating their breasts. But all his acquaintances, including the women who had followed him from Galilee, stood at a distance, watching these things happen. Let us pray. Lord Jesus,
you came to share in the darkness that threatens to put out the light of our life. May we and all who remember this day find new life in you, now and in the world to come, where you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, you give strength to the weary and new courage to those who have lost heart. Heal the sick, comfort the dying, give safety to travelers, free those unjustly deprived of liberty, and deliver your world from falsehood, hunger, and disease. Hear the prayers of all who call on you in any trouble, that they may have the light of Christ break into their lives and receive your help in their time of need. We ask this in the name of the crucified and risen Christ. Amen.